We welcome you to St George's, the parish church of Great and Little Bromley, on this Advent Sunday for our service from darkness to light. We begin the service with the church in darkness as we look towards the flickering light of the Advent candle at the west of the church. The light of this candle speaks to us of Jesus Christ, whose light pierces through the darkness in our world. The darkness that surrounds us now speaks of the forces of disease, poverty, and hatred, which still have such power on human lives. But the light of Jesus Christ still shines out and is not overcome. And so in Advent, we long for Christ to come among us, and we pray for the coming of his kingdom on earth. And as in a few moments the light will spread throughout the church, we meet with Christ, who is our Lord and our Judge, and we unite ourselves with him as we strive to reflect his light in the world. So in Advent, we long for Christ to come among us. We pray for the coming of his kingdom on earth. And as in a few moments the light will spread through the church, we meet with Christ, who is our Lord and our Judge, and we unite ourselves with him as we strive to reflect his light in the world. In the beginning of creation, when God made heaven and earth, the earth was without form and void, with darkness over the face of the abyss, and a mighty wind that swept over the surface of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and he separated light from darkness. He called the light day and the darkness night. So evening came and morning came, the first day. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, eternal creator of light and day. Now as darkness is falling, hear the prayer of your faithful people. Wash away our transgressions, cleanse us by your refining fire, and make us temples of your Holy Spirit. May we live in watchfulness as we wait for the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, who will judge the world and all its works. Rouse us from the sleep of sin. Make us ready to enter your kingdom where songs of praise forever sound. For you are the true light who enlightens everyone, and the new heavens and the new earth join to sing your praise, now and forevermore. Amen.
Drop down, ye heavens, from above, and let the skies pour down righteousness. Be not wroth, very sore, O Lord, neither remember iniquity forever.
It is time for us to awake out of sleep, for deliverance is nearer to us now than it was when we first believed. It is far on in the night, Day is near. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and put upon us the armour of light. Grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we begin today this solemn season of Advent, in which the Church bids us prepare to celebrate the coming of Christ, a coming that we recall in the child of Bethlehem, a coming we await when God gathers up all things in Christ. Let us in this holy season reflect on the coming of Christ, who brings light to the world. Let us leave behind the darkness of sin. Let us walk in the light that shines on our path and renew within ourselves the hope of glory to which he beckons us. And as we turn towards the light, let us have on our hearts all those who can see no light, for whom all is darkness and despair. And let us pray that they too may be illumined by Christ, who is our light. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armour of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which thy Son Jesus Christ came to visit us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And may the Lord, when he comes, find us watching and waiting, now and at all times. Amen.
A reading from the 9th chapter of Isaiah. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even for ever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Thanks be to God.
Make us your own, your holy people.
Chapter of Isaiah. Comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned. For she hath received the Lord's hand double for all her sins. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it. The voice said, cry. And he said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as the flower of the field. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, because the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people is grass. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand for ever. O Zion, that bringest good tidings, get thee up into the high mountain. O Jerusalem, that bringest good tidings, lift up thy voice with strength. Lift it up, be not afraid. Say unto the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God will come with a strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm, and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with young. Thanks be to God.
I vividly remember as a child the excitement of Advent. It was the great countdown to Christmas. And I remember as a choir boy in St. Nicholas Harwich, that great sense of anticipation in church. As the hangings all changed to purple, and we sang those wonderful Advent hymns. We always began on Advent Sunday with O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. This is a wonderful hymn that's based around five of the Advent antiphons, also known as the Great O's. These antiphons were sung at evensong before the Magnificat in the days leading up to Christmas Eve. Each antiphon is addressed to God using imagery from the Hebrew scriptures. Firstly, Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Then the root of Jesse, reminding us of Jesus' ancestry. Then the dayspring, speaking of the one who brings light to the world. Fourth antiphon speaks of the key of David, reminding us of Jesus' kingship, that he is in the line of his great ancestor. And finally, Adonai, the lawgiver, the one who gave the law on Mount Sinai. Each verse has a sense of urgency. It is a cry for deliverance for God's people. But each verse finishes with the assurance that God will come to save his people. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. This Advent, the cry for deliverance feels much more than a piece of abstract theology. With the pandemic that we have lived with for most of the last year, we have been praying for deliverance, and now it seems that that deliverance will soon come. But the Advent antiphons are a cry for deliverance for all the world, every year, for all those who suffer disease and poverty, oppression and injustice. For Advent is the season above all others when we long for God to come among us in power, to bring in his kingdom of love and peace. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Thank you. by Ryan Williams. He will come like last leaves fall, one night when the November wind has flayed the trees to bone and earth wakes choking on the mould, the soft shrouds folding. He will come like frost, one morning when the shrinking earth opens on mist to find itself arrested in the net of alien sword-set beauty. He will come like dark, one evening when the bursting red December sun draws up the sheet and penny masks its eye to yield the star-snowed fields of sky. He will come like crying in the night, like blood, like breaking, as the earth writhes to toss him free. He will come like child.
Let us pray. Watchful at all times, let us pray for strength to stand with confidence before our Maker and our Redeemer. That God may bring in his kingdom with justice and with mercy, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That God may establish among the nations his scepter of righteousness, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That God may bind up the brokenhearted, restore the sick, and raise up all who have fallen, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That the light of God's coming may dawn on all those who live in darkness and in the shadow of death, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. That with the saints in light, we may shine forth as lights in the world. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. May Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and scatter the darkness before your path. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Thank you.